Children, today we'll continue the chapter Animal Kingdom, and in this we'll do today phylum Hemichordata. Children, the body of animals belonging to this phylum is divided into proboscis, collar, and trunk. The pharynx, it is perforated by gill slits. Buccal diverticulum, which arises from the roof of buccal cavity, it is regarded as a notochord. Now it is hollow and it is called as stomochord. Now the animal is Balanoglossus. Now children, it was considered that hemichordates, they were the subphylum of chordates because they possess silk gill slits in the wall of pharynx and buccal diverticulum, which is thought to be notochord. But now it is agreed that neither they are the buccal cavity nor they are the notochords. They are the anterior projection of the digestive tract. Therefore, hemichordates, they are regarded as a separate phylum. Now the larva, it is similar to Echinoderm by pinnatial larva. Let's come to phylum chordates. Now this phylum includes about 48,000 living species and they have diagnostic features. But the three main chordate features are presence of notochord, nerve cord and paired pharyngeal gill slits. Now notochord, it is dorsal, flexible but firm solid rod that extends all along the body length and supports the body. Nerve cord, that all chordates, they have a dorsal hollow nerve cord. It is usually differentiated into brain and spinal cord. All chordates that have paired pharyngeal gill clefts during some time in their life cycle. Now here is the difference between chordates and non-chordates. Now some other characteristics of chordates are they are bilaterally symmetrical and triploblastic animals. Digestive system complete, that means starting from mouth and ends at the anus. Hemoglobin is the respiratory pigment which is present in RBCs or the red blood cells. Special respiratory organs are present in the form of gills or in the form of lungs. Now postnatal muscular tails are also present behind the anal or the cloacal aperture. Now ventral heart, in all chordates, heart lies ventral to the alimentary canal. This phylum chordate, it is further divided into three subphylum. Subphylum 1, urochordates, then 2, cephalochordate, and 3, chordates are the crinacea. Now urochordates, they are bag-like, sessile and degenerated animals. Now an adult, they are without nerve cord and notochord. The only chordate character present in adult, they are the presence of gill slits. Now nerve cord and notochord, they are present in the tail of larva, and this is called as retrogressive metamorphosis. Now examples are the Hadmania, Acidia, Toleolum, Sulpa, etc. Here is the Acidia. Now see, it's oral or the bronchial virtue, then bronchial siphon, tears, then atrial siphon, root, and substratum. So it is fixed to the substratum. Now, subphylum 2, cephalochordates. Now, cephalochordates are fish like marine animals and they have three main chordate features throughout their life: notochord, which is hollow and tubular, nerve cord, which are many in number, and gill slits, which persist throughout the life and bears a caudal fin. Example, Amphioxus or Branchostoma. Next is the subphylum Vertebrata or the Crinacea. Now division of body divided into head, neck, trunk and tail. Now there are external segmentation but they are not visible, and internal segmentation or metamerism, it is evident from the muscles, vertebrae and the ribs. Appendages, they have two sets of paired appendages. They may be paired in fishes and limbs in others. Body, it is without exoskeleton as in some fishes and all amphibians. Other, it is represented by scales, plates, feathers and hair. Now endoskeleton, above of cartilage or bones. They are present in all vertebrates and they are differentiated into exoskeleton and appendicular skeleton. Exoskeleton, it is the median axis and it is differentiated into cranium around brain and vertebral column or backbone and crossed with the spinal cord. And appendicular skeleton, it supports the paired appendages which help in locomotion. Now, muscles, they have both types of muscles, striated and non-striated. Now, body cavity, it is spacious in nature and it is filled with body fluid and it contains a visceral loosely suspended by mesenteries from the dorsal body wall. Now, a well-developed respiratory organs are present in aquatic vertebrates. They have gills and in terrestrial animals, they have lungs for respiration. Circulatory system, it is of closed type. Heart is ventral. Vertebrates, they have hepatic portal and renal portal system. They are meant for different purpose. Now, excretory organ, kidneys are present for the excretion and respiratory osmoregulation process. Now, the nervous system, it is differentiated into brain and spinal cord. Sense organs, they are located on the head. All vertebrates, they possess well-developed endocrine glands and they secrete chemical messengers called hormones, and these hormones, they control different metabolic and reproductive activities. Classification of subphylum vertebrate children, we will learn in our next class. Till then, goodbye, have a nice day.